everyone, it's Diane and this is the Angel Hug for Monday the 29th of April, and I'm going to start with the secret language of colour cards. And I've kind of got in the back of my mind as a theme the idea of overcoming resistance, because I've actually felt this quite strongly recently in my own life and in the lives of other people, friends and the people that I help. And really what I'm going to be asking this week, maybe not throughout the whole week, but it's going to be kind of at the back of my mind, is how can we overcome resistance? Or rather, when I was talking about it to my guides earlier, I was saying, well, what is it that we're actually talking about here? And the sense I got was, well, what does it feel like to not be resisting? And I felt, well, it's freedom, isn't it? It's something like that. It's something like freedom. That's how it felt to me. So that was the question that was given to us. How does it feel when you don't resist? How does it feel when you allow yourself to be free? What do you try for? What do you go for? Where do you go? Who do you speak to? Where does your life take you? Where do you allow life to take you? How are you resisting the natural flow, the stream of possibility of the truth of your life? And how do you know the difference? When do you know when you're resisting and when you're actually just using a no? So it's all of that thrown into the mix. And I really just want to kind of tune into a frequency of it, because what it feels like is the beginning of the year has been very important for planting little seeds, or being aware of little seeds and little shoots of possibility under the snow. I think I talked about that last week. And now it feels like it's the spring. For a lot of us, it's a new sensation of actually manifesting the things that we were kind of thinking we would sort of like to see happen. And here is where we stand at the doorway. And yet so many of us are not walking through the door. So what is it that stops us walking through the door, even when we're actually in the stream of something that we've created ourselves, that we've wanted ourselves, that we've been hoping for? And I'm just going to pick a card now, because I feel like I've said enough and I want to pick a card. Right, so rejoice and laugh. That's the card for Monday on the subject of how to become freer. That's what we're talking about, freeing ourselves. It doesn't matter. It's not as important as we think it is. We have to keep a sense of humour about everything, because at some point we're going to look back at this time and laugh. So let's just start the laughter now. Let's start the laughter now, in the sense that it can help us to see things as they really are, to put things into perspective, to stop taking it all so seriously and heavily. So what if you make a wrong choice? So what if you try it and it doesn't quite work? So what if you try it and it works, but you make a fool of yourself sometimes? So what, so what, so what? Who's really going to remember? Who's really going to be worrying about it rather than you worrying yourself into an early ascension? It's just not worth it. So really the message here is, have some fun today, and whatever it is that you're resisting, if it really feels like it's the truth of your life and of your heart that you're holding back, have a look in the mirror, have a good laugh at yourself, have a laugh at the situation, put it into perspective and look at it and say, well, okay, I'm not being asked to run a country here. How big is this thing that I'm resisting? How big and how important is it really? And have a good laugh at yourself for actually thinking it's something that you can't do or can't overcome or can't be free about. And laughter is very freeing. So whether you're resisting or not, the message for today is, have some fun, have a laugh, find people you can laugh with. Don't hang out with people who are just as intense as you are. Find the people who will have a good old laugh at all of it and who will help you to feel freer and go into the rest of the week with that sense of freedom. And I feel I'm going to pick another card. I've just had the nod. Live an extraordinary life. So where are you afraid of living an extraordinary life? What is stopping you from just saying, okay, it's all right for me to do something that is extraordinary, in the sense that it's either very different to what most people do, or it's larger than life, or in some other way, it's very specifically me. And because I'm extraordinary, extraordinary, you know, more than ordinary, not just kind of fitting into someone else's mold, because I'm extraordinary, that life will be extraordinary if I trust the vision of me, the truth of me, my uniqueness, and just go into that vision in full faith and live that life. So these are the messages for today. Laugh at yourself and be as weird as you really are, and just allow that to let you live an extraordinary life. Just don't try to live anybody else's life, because they really don't know what they're doing either. There's no such thing as normal. There's no such thing as normality, essentially. So have a good old laugh. And when you've finished laughing at your limitations, be extraordinary and enjoy it. Right, that's it for today. I'll be back tomorrow. Bye.